Hello, lovely people. It's me again. Welcome back to my channel. Please subscribe and help a sister if you are not already subscribed. Today we are going to prepare this beautiful and delicious Ghana vegetable spring roll. You will love it. Let's start with the ingredients. I have got my cabbage, raw cabbage. I have got carrots that I have cut and onions that I have cut into stripes. I have got grated ginger and garlic, and I have also got mackerel fillets in sardine. You can use whatever you have. You can use whatever you have at home. I've got my curry powder. It gives it flavor, so you would want to add that. And of course, I've got my spring roll sheets already. It's frozen, but if you leave it for like a couple of minutes, it will defrost and you can use it. And I've got my olive oil that I'm using to fry. So I'll go ahead and prepare my filling. Yeah, so I'm starting with the filling. So I'll go in with my carrot first, because carrot is quite hard, so I'll toss it up for a few minutes, 2 minutes, and I'll add my onions to it, and I'll go ahead and add all of them eventually. So let's go. Go ahead and add in my grated ginger and my grated garlic. Ghana spring roll is on another level. It's so delicious. Especially the vegetable one, the one I'm making, is so delicious. It's so much flavored. As you can see, there's ginger, there's garlic, there's curry powder. So, you know, you take time and make it. So, there's so much love in there. So, it's moist from the inside and crunchy on the outside. So, Ghana spring roll, you would want to try it. It's so delicious. And so now I'll go ahead and add my stock cube to it, and I'm adding half of it, so you can add salt to taste. If you taste it and see and there's not enough salt, you can add salt to taste. So now mine is okay because I don't like too much salt now. So I'll go ahead and add my mackerel. You can as well add whatever you have at home. I mean, it's your taste, so you make it how you want it to taste. So this is what I have, this is what I'm using, but it's nice. Try it this way, you will love it. And I'll add my curry powder from Ghana. You can add any other garlic powder you have at home. This is what I have at home. Now, the reason why I'm adding everything and not the cabbage is I don't want the cabbage to be too soft. I want a little bit of crunch inside. Now, I'm adding chili flakes. It's totally optional. You can omit it if you don't want heat, but it's cold, so I want a kick of some heat, you know. So now it's ready. I think this is cooked now. So I'll go ahead and add my cabbage, as I don't want the cabbage to be too soft. And I think the cabbage is too much, so I'm just adding a little, half of it, and I'll leave the half in freezer. I can use it next time. Use the flavors together, so you leave it on for a while, keep stirring so that the other side will not be too soft than the other. So now you can go ahead and do your thing, but I think it's ready now. I don't want it to be too soft, you know, so it's okay, it's ready. I have got my board and I've got my spring roll sheets ready. So let's go ahead and fill in and roll it. So with this, it's easy to make, you know. You would want to be generous. Just put enough filling in there. And this is the way I fold or I roll my spring roll, so that it doesn't, when you put it in the hot oil, it doesn't open and the filling will not come out. It's easy this way. So I've got my, you can use egg, but I am using flour to seal it. So yeah, so this is the fold. Let me show you. You fold it one, cover it, and fold the sides. In that way you flocked it, it cannot come out. Then you continue the process, keep rolling. That is where the name comes from, spring roll. And you seal it. This is it, that beautiful. So you see, I've got that. Now you can do it the other way. You can, this is also allowed. Use the other corner to do it. So now look at this. You're filling on the far end of your sheets. So now you fold it and cover it. You keep rolling. When you get to the middle, you fold the sides. And you continue the process, rolling process, and you seal it. It's that simple. Yes, that simple and beauty. Continue the process, you seal it up so they don't get open with they touches the hot oil. So yeah, it's that simple and easy. now we are doing the last batch, and you can also do it a lot or as much as you want and keep some in the freezer anytime you wish or you want to eat spring roll. You just open your freezer, heat your oil and fry it for yourself. That simple. You want to fry it on a medium low heat. You don't want to fry it on a very high heat because it burns very quickly. So you want to do it on a low, and you don't fry it for too long because the filling is already cooked. You're just frying this light sheet, so you don't fry it for long. Some people want it very brown, but I want it somehow golden brown, not too brown. So it's at this point, it's totally your choice how you want it. But for me, I think it's almost done, so it's totally up to you. So moist on the inside and so crunchy on the outside. You can fry it more brown than this, but this is how I want it. It's so delicious, it's so moist and it's so nice. Just try and make some for yourself. You will love it. You will love it. Make something good for yourself. So this is the end of the video. Thank you for watching. Bye. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.